So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Beboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click onto any of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions in what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub on my channel. It is appreciated. So Virgil Hunter, the head trainer of Andre Ward, says that after Andre Ward's big victory over Sergey Kovalev last weekend, in which he stopped Sergey Kovalev in 8 rounds, in many people's eyes, in controversial fashion, due to it apparently being a low blow, that Andre Ward landed a series of low blows that caused the referee to stop the fight. A lot of people are arguing, saying it was the belt line, people are saying it was a low blow, just so many mixed opinions. Like, I didn't want this second fight to be controversial, and even though Andre Ward did stop Sergey Kovalev, people are still going to say it's controversial. But anyway, Virgil Hunter wants Andre Ward to eventually move up to heavyweight and even fight somebody like Anthony Joshua. He says he'd love Andre Ward to fight Anthony Joshua. He says that Andre Ward could outbox Anthony Joshua. And to quote Virgil Hunter here, he says, fighting a bigger man, it doesn't have to do with size. It has to do with his attributes and their attributes. If you were to single out one thing that would make it a competitive fight for yourself, you take that chance, because that's what he's here for. I'd like to see him fight Anthony Joshua. I'm not playing, I'm serious. I think it would be a very interesting fight. I know you've got a lot of people to say, oh, that's suicide, but there are some things about Anthony Joshua that I see that makes me think he can outbox Joshua. I see him outboxing Anthony Joshua. There are some things about Joshua that I see. He's a good kid, I know him, but I just see things with him in particular, and he's the best. But styles make fights. It'll be a waste of time to go to Cruiser. Just leapfrog it and go for it all. So Virgil Hunter doesn't want Andre Ward to go up to cruiserweight. He wants him to go to heavyweight and try and pick up a very prestigious heavyweight title against somebody like WBA and IBF champion Anthony Joshua. And in my opinion, that would be a very big mistake from Andre Ward. Because yes, Andre Ward is fantastically gifted in terms of boxing IQ. He is a technical master when he gets into the ring. And against Sergey Kovalev the other night, he seemed to up his game from the first fight, and he looked very well, Andre Ward, even though the fight was very competitive. But sometimes a guy's just too big, and in my opinion, Andre Ward is leaps and bounds ahead of somebody like Anthony Joshua in terms of technical ability. But sometimes that doesn't matter, because the guy can just be too big. And Anthony Joshua would be too big for Andre Ward. He's what, 6-7 inches bigger than Andre Ward in height. He's what, 30-40 pounds bigger than him in terms of weight. If he was to move up to heavyweight right now, Anthony Joshua is what, 70 pounds heavier than Andre Ward in terms of weight divisions. And Anthony Joshua has what, got an 82 inch reach, and Andre Ward's got a 71 inch reach. That's 11 inches difference in reach. That's massive. And yeah, Andre Ward is a technical master, but Anthony Joshua is just too big in my opinion. And I think any heavyweight is too big for Andre Ward. Maybe somebody like Joseph Parker, who's only what, 6'3", but at the end of the day, Joseph Parker is 6'3", and he's 240 pounds, so he'd still be very much bigger than an Andre Ward. So I don't know about Andre Ward moving up to heavyweight. Yes, it's been done before by Roy Jones Jr. He moved up from light heavyweight to take on WBA heavyweight champion John Ruiz at the time, and he beat him over 12 rounds. But the thing was, John Ruiz wasn't really a massive threat in the heavyweight division. Don't get me wrong, John Ruiz was a decent fighter at heavyweight, but he wasn't a massive superstar. He wasn't seen as very, very dangerous. And the thing about Roy Jones Jr. was, Roy Jones had fantastic athleticism. He wasn't the most technically gifted fighter, and I'd argue anyone who disagrees on that, because Roy Jones Jr. wasn't a technically gifted fighter. He was just very, very athletic, fantastic athleticism, very quick, and his reflexes were just absolutely off the charts. And he hit hard as well. He hit a lot harder than somebody like Andre Ward. Andre Ward isn't the fastest guy. He doesn't hit very hard. He hasn't got the fastest hand speed. He hasn't got the fastest feet. Don't get me wrong, he's not slow footed and he hasn't got slow hands, but he's not the fastest. He's not like somebody like a Roy Jones Jr. But the thing Andre Ward does have is that he's very technically gifted and he knows what he's doing in that ring. Everything he does is a move. He's going over it in his head. Obviously, he's just computing what he's seeing off his opponent, and then he obviously he's retaliating with his own. So, yeah, it's very interesting. The remarks by Virgil Hunter, because I don't see that happening. I just see Anthony Joshua being way too big for somebody like Andre Ward. There's still big fights for Andre Ward at like heavyweight. This guy's like Adonis Stevenson, Artur Beterbiev, and Godzvik. There are a couple of fights for Andre Ward at light heavyweight, but at this stage in Andre Ward's career, can he get up for them fights? Can he get up for the contenders in the light heavyweight division? Can he get up for an Adonis Stevenson, or does he want a challenge? He already took the challenge of moving up from super middleweight to light heavyweight to take on Sergey Kovalev. Does he want another big challenge? Does he want to take on Anthony Joshua? But in my opinion, that would be a mistake on Andre Ward's part, because yeah, on a technical point of view, he's better than Anthony Joshua, but Anthony Joshua is just way too big. So yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's Speed Boxing.